Hi, my name is Rosemary Barnes and I'm a mechanical engineer. Today I'm going to talk to you about the path that I took through school and afterwards to get me to where I am in my career today. So starting off with school, I went to government school in Canberra and I did a lot of maths. My dad's actually a mathematician and he really enjoys doing maths just for fun. So I was subjected to that as a kid, which I didn't enjoy at the time, but one really great benefit from that was that I always understood that I was good at maths. Even if I didn't get a great result on a test, I knew from all that early experience that I was capable, and I actually never doubted it all the way through to university, which I feel really grateful for now. When I was at primary school, outside of school, I liked to do things like baking and sewing and playing with Barbies. I did ballet for a long time, maybe not the really traditional activities that you would think of that would prepare you to be an engineer, but I actually think that some of those things are really great preparation for being an engineer, especially like baking is really good preparation for any kind of hands-on science. You get really good skills that will help you in your labs later on in high school and university. And then sewing is definitely engineering, and I don't think that it gets enough credit as a pastime, but you know, you're taking a 2D piece of fabric and turning it into something three-dimensional, and that's actually quite advanced engineering skills. So I think that was really great preparation. I also, in addition to those sorts of things, I did a lot of sports. So I was doing cross-country running and I started mountain biking when I was, I think, 11. My brothers did a race and I needed to do it too, so I took the Dole Seed and the Streamers and the Spokey Dokes off my bike and I did a race. And that's when I first became interested in composite materials. All the best bikes were made out of carbon fiber, and I just really loved the possibilities that this fairly new material presented for, you know, making all sorts of products better. Obviously you see it a lot of places now, more so than you did back then in the 90s, in cars and wind industry, obviously, airplanes. Composite materials is changing design possibilities for nearly everything. Then for high school, I also went to a government school. I started cycling a bit more seriously when a PE teacher suggested that me and some friends should start racing. So we were racing on the road and track, and I also got my first part-time job at a bike shop. So that was really good in developing my mechanical skills and getting experience with using tools. That came in very handy later on in university when we had labs to do. In high school, it's when I realized that I liked science. I had some really supportive teachers that helped with that. And then in the ACT, we do year 11 and 12 at a separate school, which we call college. And so once I got there, I had really amazing maths teachers, and especially science and physics teachers. So basically all I wanted to do was maths and science at that point. So then at the end of year 12, obviously I had to choose what to do at university. I loved physics so much and I wanted to study physics at university, but my dad suggested to me that actually a lot of the best and most interesting physics jobs go to engineers and that I should consider choosing engineering instead. I remember at the time, even though my older brother was studying engineering, I didn't actually know what it was, but I found out that first and second year of a physics and an engineering degree are actually very similar, so it wasn't a big risk to start off in engineering. I thought I could always change to physics later if I wanted to. But once I got to university and started to learn a bit more about what engineering means, I knew that I had picked the right thing. I love studying physics, but I really like to use physics to then change the world. And so that's what I love most about engineering, is that if you find a problem, then engineering is going to give you a way to find a solution to that problem. So it's a really good way to help make the world the kind of place that you wish it would be. So for me, I'm really concerned about the environment and about climate change specifically. So I wanted to go into engineering and renewable energy. I had early work experience in quite a wide variety of industries. My first part-time job was at a bike shop, and I got a lot of good mechanical skills from that. And then while I was at university, we had to do work experience, and I did mine at the Film and Sound Archives. I was an assistant electrical engineer, and that was a really fun job with a really, really great group of people. Yeah, I also worked at a water utility, at a startup company for solar research, and I was consulting for quite a few years working on different sustainability and renewables projects for a really wide variety of companies. So eventually I became a little bit frustrated, or maybe a little bit bored, with the kinds of projects that I was working on here. I really wanted to get back to composite materials, which I had loved ever since I started cycling as a teenager. And I knew that I would need some more education before I could get a job in that field, because the composite materials that you learn in a bachelor's degree is only just kind of the tip of the iceberg. It's a complex manufacturing process. It's complex for design. I also wanted to work on bigger renewables projects and with a large manufacturing company. I'd done a lot of work with small companies in Australia, but I really wanted to experience what it was like to work in a really large manufacturing company. So I knew that to get that kind of a job, I would need more education. So I went back to university and got my PhD. I did a structural design project for a wind turbine design. And then after that, I was able to get a job at a wind turbine blade manufacturer in Denmark. It was a big change to move over here to Denmark. The language, obviously, the culture. The biggest thing for me has been the weather. But for my career, it gave me some opportunities I could never have had in Australia. Working for a large manufacturer, I've spent a lot of time in the factories supporting new product development. I have also climbed turbines around the world in Sweden and in Canada. Climbing turbines is really, really fun. That was a big professional highlight for me, but it is also exhausting. It's so satisfying to see products that I had worked on from, you know, first hearing about the problem, coming up with a concept, testing it, manufacturing it, and then seeing it working in a turbine, making green energy that would otherwise not have existed if it weren't for that technology. That is incredibly satisfying. And for me, the reason why I know I will always be an engineer, to get that kind of feedback and feel the contribution that you're making, is really important to me.